So let's know about this inflammatory bowel disease. Inflammatory bowel disease, as such, it's divided into two subtypes: Crohn disease and ulcerative colitis. Both are idiopathic and chronic disorders. There is ulceration seen, but the difference, as the name suggests, there is inflammatory. There is inflammation in the bowel. It is chronic type of inflammation. It is idiopathic, but in Crohn's and ulcerative there are difference. So that's why we have divided into two subtypes in inflammatory bowel disease. So what is the difference? The whole thing will be about these difference only. What is the difference between Crohn's and ulcerative? Okay. Crohn's disease is transmural, which means that you have four layers in your colon: mucosa, muscular layer, serosa, rectum tissue. So transmural means it involves all the four layers. The inflammation is in all four layers, and important to note is it is non-caseating type of granuloma is seen. You know that there is caseating type of granuloma somewhere in other diseases. Here it is non-caseating, which means that there is no caseation or liquefaction in the center of the necrosis. Okay, and more commonly it is seen in terminal ileum. Diagram here, you know, this is intestine. Okay, this is cecum, and you have put on a small appendix, ascending colon, transverse colon, descending colon, sigmorectal junction, and all those things. Okay, this is more common in terminal ileum and colon, whereas ulcerative colitis. Ulcerative colitis is more in rectum and ascending colon. Rectum and ascending colon. Okay. That is, ulcerative colitis involves only two layers: mucosa and submucosa, not all the four layers. Important to know. Okay. Also, coming on to pathogenesis. Pathology, you have to know the pathogenesis. So we divide the pathogenesis into four types. Okay, etiology has four types. Etiology pathogenesis is four types. One is due to genetic. Then, whenever there is inflammatory bowel disease, it is worth to know that there is alternation in the host interaction with the intestinal microbiota. Interaction with host and microbiota. And intestinal epithelial dysfunction, aberrant mucosal inflammation, and last is there is microbiota is altered in our intestine. Okay, so remember, whenever there is pathology, the etiology of inflammatory bowel disease is there is alternation in the host interaction with intestinal microbiota. Intestinal epithelial dysfunction is there. Aberrant mucosal immune response will be there. And there is the composition of the gut microbiome is altered. How these changes will be there? Because of four reasons. First is genetics. Affected family members and monozygous twins. Genetically related inheritance is seen in such individuals. This genetics is more in Crohn's disease than for ulcerative colitis. Okay, the genes that are affected is NOT2 gene. NOT2 gene abbreviated as nucleotide oligomerization binding domain 2. NOT gene encodes for intracellular protein. This protein binds to bacterial peptidoglycan of bacteria. This activates the signaling pathway, that is NFK kappa beta. Okay, so this is due to not to gene, NFK beta will cause intestinal dysfunctions, epithelial dysfunctions. Okay. So, and this, these two. So, genetically, main important thing is not to gene. Okay, and there are also HLA studies like MHC, now it is called as MHC studies. The alternation in HLA, DR, B1 allele, HRAT, DR4, DR7. So these are shown that they have these kind of alleles. The patients have these type of alleles in them. And then you have second is mucosal immune response. Mucosal immune response is that your mucosa in production, in counteracting, in order to counteract bacteria or some any invasion, will have some response of its own. So normally cytokine inhibitory to inflammations, there are cytokines which inhibits the inflammation, like interleukin 10 and tumor growth factor, tissue growth factor beta. These two are those cytokines which inhibits the inflammation. By suppressing the mechanism of inflammation, immune mechanism, if these are defective, they result in uncontrolled inflammation. Okay, they result in uncontrolled inflammation. But also important to know is, you have T helper cells now. T helper cells has two subsets, TH1 and TH2. TH1 will release interferon gamma and tumor necrosis factor, which are the causative agent for transmural inflammation in Crohn's disease. TH1 is for Crohn's disease. TH2 will release interleukin 4, 5 and 13, which are responsible for superficial mucosal inflammation in ulcerative colitis. Okay. And also you have another TH subtype 17, which releases interleukin 23, which is also is a causative agent for mucosal immune response. Okay. And then the third reason for the causation of inflammatory bowel disease is epithelial defects. Epithelial defects may be due to defect in tight junction barrier or extracellular matrix protein. These two epithelial defects may be seen in ulcerative colitis, which may be the causative agent for the development of ulcers. And also microbiota, normal microbiota will become pathogenic, okay, or otherwise the cells become more responsive to the bacteria by producing the receptors, okay. And this was, and also psychological factors have been observed for the causative agent, and also smoking, oral contraceptives, maybe the intrinsic factors. So as I said, there are two types of inflammatory bowel disease: ulcerative colitis and Crohn's disease. So a very easy mnemonic to remember these two things: Crohn's for sister CG, ulcerative colitis for U colitis. Okay. Skip S, I'll be abbreviating these things. In Crohn's disease, you will be seeing skip lesions, more common in ileum. Then ulcers will be serpentine in nature. The ulcer is transmural. There is extra fibrosis fistula. Usually rectum is paired. Also R is for radiologically, you see string sign, spelling mistake is there, okay. And C for cobblestone appearance, grossly, and externally, in the serosa, you have creeping fat. Okay, mesenteric fat extension around the serosa is called as creeping fat. And typically, it is a non-caseating granuloma. As I said before, TH1 subtype type cells are responsible for this inflammation type. Okay. Got it? Sister CGTH1. Sleep lesions, ileum, serpentine type of ulcers, it is transmural. There may be extra fibrosis fistula. Rectum is paired. There is cobblestone appearance and creeping fact. There is warm case-eating granuloma formation. Ulcerative colitis, the pneumonic is eucolitis, TH2. Okay, U4, it is a ulcer which is superficial. That is, it is meant to say that it involves only mucosa and submucosa. It is continuous type of lesions. Here it is skip type of lesion. And it originates in the rectum. After, once you do barium meal, barium swallow, you can see lead pipe appearance in this ulcerative colitis. There is increased chance of cancer for ulcerative colitis than for chronic Crohn's disease. There may be formation of toxic megacolon as a complication. Symptoms are more severe than Crohn's disease, and the TH2 type of cells are responsible for this type of inflammation. Okay. Saying the differences grossly and microscopically. This is a microscopic view of Crohn's disease. Okay. They have said that histological features present like transmural chronic inflammation, deep fissure into bowel wall, submucosal widening, this widening is there due to edema, prominent lymphocytes are there, and very importantly you have a non-caseating cell granuloma of the bowel wall. See again, granuloma, but there is no caseous as you see in tuberculosis. So here you see there is necrosis, but there is no cessation. You can see gain cells. There is necrosis. Okay. This is for ulcerative colitis. So only superficial ulceration is seen. Cryptopsis means that near the crypt there is accumulation of this polymorphonuclear cells or inflammatory cells. Okay. And mucodepletion. Congested vessels, inflammation, there is inflammation. Okay. See, there is no granuloma here. Okay. And there is only superficial ulceration. There is no infiltration into deep as you saw in the previous slide. See, there is infiltration throughout the layers or the four layers. Okay. Also, what are they clinically, how they differ? This Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis. Intermittent attack of mild diarrhea is seen. Fever and abdominal pain. Right quadrant pain in Crohn's disease, whereas there is lower abdominal pain and there is midline epigastric pain in this ulcerative colitis. Bloody diarrhea, you also maybe see, you can see bloody diarrhea. Due to complications, there may be iron deficiency, anemia, strictures, formations. You have got some extra intestine manifestation for this inflammatory bowel disease. For Crohn's disease, you have uveitis, migratory polyarthritis, sarcolitis, ankylosing spondylitis, erythema nodosum, clubbing of fingers, polycholangitis, primary sclerosing cholangitis. And there may be risk of colonic. Okay. And for ulcerative colitis, extra-intestinal manifestations are migratory polyarthritis, sarcolitis, ankylosing spondylitis, uveitis, skin lesions, primary sclerosis, cholangitis. So these are extra-intestinal manifestation because there is overall inflammatory increased response of inflammation, or there are genetically inherited defects. Okay. So these tables tells you all the difference between Crohn's disease and ulcerative colitis. Macroscopically, there is skip lesions, that is continuous lesions. Commonly situated in terminal ileum and ascending colon. Here in the ulcerative colitis, commonly seen in rectum ascending colon. Okay. Extent, usually the entered thickness, that is transmural. And ulcerative colitis is only superficial. Ulcers are serpentine ulcers. Okay. Serpentine, snake-like. Okay. And the fissures, deep fissures may be seen in Crohn's disease. Ulcerative colitis, those are not seen. Pseudopolyps are rarely seen. Here, commonly present because, you know, that was something else. Okay. Cobblestone mucosa is typical of Crohn's disease. Fibrosis or stricture formations are complications of this Crohn's disease, not of ulcerative disease. Microscopically, inflammation is transmural, there is superficial. It is granulomatous, non-caseating type of inflammation. There is cryptopsis, non-specific, acute or chronic inflammatory cells will be there. Mucosa is patchy ulceration. And Crohn's ulcerative disease, there is hemorrhagic mucosa with ulceration. Submucosa is edematous, widened. In ulcerative colitis, is normal. Okay, immunologic features, TH1 cells, TH2 cells. And another important thing is ANCAP antibodies. ANCAP antibodies are positive in only few cases of Crohn's disease, but positive in most cases of ulcerative colitis. Complications, fistula formations is and fibrous strictures are common in Crohn's disease, whereas malignant changes is more common in ulcerative colitis, and there may be complication like toxic megacolon in ulcerative colitis. So to divide one thing, inflammatory bowel disease, two types are there. Pathogenesis, genetic, mucosal immune response, epithelial defect, microbiota. The difference, Crohn's disease, sister CG, and ulcerative colitis, superficial, your colitis, TH2, your TH1. This is the pictures of microscopic view of Crohn's disease, deep fissure, granuloma, okay, edema. Okay, here in ulcerative colitis only superficial abscess, cryptabscess, there is no edema here. Okay, only superficial ulcers are seen, and this is the difference between clinically how to differentiate ulcerative colitis and Crohn's disease. Okay, this was all in the about what I have done about ulcerative inflammatory bowel disease.